In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brothers and sisters, warm greetings from the Carmelite Fathers and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's gospel. It's the 5th of August, Monday of the 18th week in ordinary time. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 14 verses 13 to 21. At that time, when Jesus heard of the death of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a lonely place apart. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. As he went ashore, he saw a great throng, and he had compassion on them and healed their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a lonely place, and the day is now over. Send the crowds away to go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They said to him, "We have only 5 loaves here and 2 fish." And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. And taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke and gave the loaves to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds, and they all ate and were satisfied. And they took up 12 baskets full of the broken pieces left over, and those who ate were about 5,000 men besides women and children. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Ecclesia in Asia. Post-synodal apostolic exhortation given by Pope St. John Paul II on November 6, 1999. Acknowledges that only Jesus can fully satisfy the intense yearnings of people for God. Only Jesus can fully satisfy the intense yearnings of people for God. Hence, this exhortation encourages the church in Asia to proclaim with vigor in word and deed that Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. Since the Bible is meant to be bread for daily use and not cake for special occasions, we need to be familiar with the Word of God if we need to be fed with the bread of life. The touching act of Jesus, what is that? Feeding the 5,000 in the Bible discloses us some truths about God. God multiplies the little we have and brings great blessings. But we need to bring the little we have to God. Finally, the miracle of the multiplication of the loaves. Jesus blesses the loaves, breaks and distributes it to feed the multitude, is a sign that prefigures the unique bread blessed and broken during the Eucharist to satisfy the spiritual hunger of the faithful. Furthermore, He blesses us with more than we need, so that we share with the needy and in turn become a blessing to others. In this way, God takes the little we have, multiplies it, and gives us back, both for our good and also for the good of others. But this is only realizable when we learn to be generous and start sharing with the needy, acknowledging that the abundance we have is the fruit of God's generosity. Mahatma Gandhi once rightly said, "There are people in the world so hungry that God cannot appear to them except in the form of bread. While praying the prayer, Our Father, we make the following petition: Give us this day our daily bread. As we pray so, we acknowledge that God is the one who provides us bread." Let us pray. It's the birthday of Lucy Lobo from Kuppepadav and Jason Furtado from Bengaluru. May God bless their intentions and their life, and wish you a happy birthday, and also our brothers and sisters among the listeners of Carmel Light who celebrate the gift of life today. Lord, give us a generous heart and a spirit of sharing. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.